you doing?
Today I'd like to review the chlorimeter CL3000 rapid field analysis kit for chloride. Basically, the idea of this is that we use a chloride ion selective electrode and the handy dandy meter that goes with it to rapidly test the amount of chloride in a 3-gram sample. So the kit comes with a drill bit, two drill bits, frankly. The first drill bit, larger drill bit, is to create the sample. The second drill bit is to hold one of these clamps in place. So this being the sampling pan, you want to clamp it in place. Provide the clamp. This is the concrete anchor to use to hold the clamp. Small open and closed in wrench. And some bolts for the clamp. So you have the smaller drill bit to drill holes for the anchor. And you have the larger bit to drill a hole for the sample. This tool here is designed to set the anchor in place. Moving right on from there. We have a little scale. This will allow you to weigh out the 3-gram sample. And you will need either a CL1212, which is what this is, or CL2096, which is 100 of these samples. And you place the 3-gram sample in the extraction liquid and give it a shake. You can pretty much start taking readings immediately. They'll begin to steady out after 3 to 4 hours. It's an exponential increase, so the majority of the digestion will happen in the initial 10-15 minutes, certainly 3 to 5, but the full digestion will take a few hours. Some practitioners like to just let them sit overnight. Some will take the readings after 3 to 5 minutes. It just varies upon the practitioner. What we also have here is the calibration solutions. Each one is calibrated for different percent levels by weight of chloride. This one's 0.3%, going down to 0.05%. Please understand that this is a very low level of chloride, and it's very easy to contaminate the 0.005%, the 0.01%, and the 0.05%. So this is the chloride ion selective electrode. This cable is somewhat stiff and sensitive. Don't cramp or mash this cable down tightly. You'll pretty much destroy the electrode. You'll be up. These are not cheap. They're about $1,000. So we don't want that to happen. First, you have to prep the electrode. And that will consist of, hopefully I can do this correctly, pouring the ion selective wetting agent into this little hole here. So you can either do it with the spout here, or the provided syringe, which fits in there. You fill the wetting agent, put it in there. We'll need to take this cap off to take a reading, and you want to loosen this slightly and give it a slight push. I can loosen it more to show. Slight push to allow the wetting agent to get down near the tip. It doesn't have to be on the tip. It should get down here near the tip. You want to fill the wetting solution about 2/3 to 3/4. And just remember that the hole to fill it is typically behind the rubber try this. There we go. Now we got a mover. So by pumping it like this, you should get it around the outside of the electrode and then reseal the electrode back in there. Okay. The unit does come with some batteries. Also comes with a power supply if you've run out of battery power. Pop these in. You're not using a piece of equipment, especially like this, that you're probably going to use intermittently. It's always a good idea to remove the batteries. System also comes with some distilled water. Probably realistically going to need more distilled water. Every time you use this electrode and place it in anything, you're going to have to wash it pretty thoroughly with distilled water and dry it off with some paper towels. So here we have, you attach the BNC connector and the 3mm connector. We're not using this electrode. You want to keep it covered. This is a pretty sensitive sensor right here, and you really want to keep it covered as much as possible. So you have some options here: measure or calibrate. Calibrate is the option, set clock or upload to a PC. Configure, review to review your tests. You want to start with a calibration. Basically, you want to calibrate the electrode every 3 to 5 hours, or if there's a significant change in temperature. For example, if you're working indoors and then you're moving it outdoors. Calibration is simply done by taking readings. This would be of the 0.5%. If you're getting a not okay, and if you've already, unfortunately, it's very easy to do, contaminated one of the solutions, just hit the arrow key. Cut the line. Yeah, just hit the arrow key down, and you can move onto the next solution. Yeah, so after you've gone through the calibration procedure, you want to move on to measure. And this is going to read out the percent chloride by weight. After you've put your 3-gram sample in the chloride extraction liquid, you then want to insert the electrode. With the wetting agent inside, you want to insert the electrode into the extraction liquid and wait for a stable reading here. I mean, right now it's just reading crazy stuff. I don't know what it's going to do to my finger here. Yeah, it's not being very stable. But it will get stable in the extraction liquid. Some key takeaway points. Be careful when you're doing a profile. You don't want to contaminate your samples as you're bringing them up. So you want to do a sample, clean everything out thoroughly with a blower or a similar device. You want to keep your electrode as clean as possible between readings. That's why we have the distilled water and the spray pump. So you can either use the spray pump or you can use the cap. It's probably realistically going to take quite a bit of distilled water to keep it clean. We also have the cable for uploading data to the PC. We have a small polishing strip for the electrode. You may want to polish it after 100 or so readings. It really shouldn't get that, it really should not get that dirty. You should take the time to keep it clean as possible. Don't go really heavy-handed on the polishing strip. You also, when you fill this, you want to make sure that that there's very little air in there. So you want to tap it so there's bubbles come out of it, so that it gives a nice steady reading. We just want to reiterate the importance of keeping everything clean and dry. So it really only is going to take a few drops of liquid in the 0.005% for this to be contaminated and be no longer any good. Similarly with the 0.01%, this is not a high volume of chloride in the solution. It is also, for good results, very important that you keep the samples separate, particularly when you're using the sampling pan, that you clean off the sampling pan so you don't contaminate one sample with chloride, with concrete dust from another sample. So it's very, very important. This can all be done in the field. Maybe a small work table can be brought. Certainly people have had success with these in the field, and it's been a great product for us over the years.
So this is a quick review of the chlorimeter chloride system for field chloride testing. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to us, either via email at info@ndtjames.com, fill out the form on our website at ndtjames.com, or give us a call, 1-800-426-6500 in the U.S., or +1-773-463-6565 if you're outside the U.S. We are here to support you and your projects, and let's get this job done.